friends and family. We are in Kansas on this April the 10th at about 9:55 a.m. It's a little bit windy. We drove through quite a bit of rain, starting out in Memphis, and then Alex had some rain last night. It looks pretty clear so far today. It is windy, so it's kind of tossing us around a little bit, but nothing scary windy. It's just little gusts that kind of move us around a little bit. Coming up on a wind farm up here. Anyhow, good morning. So for whatever reason, the navigation, it decided that it wanted to take us through Arkansas, Oklahoma, up through Kansas under the 70. We're going to go up through Denver to Wyoming, to Cheyenne, and then to 80 over, which this is the exact same trip that we had coming from Salt Lake to Memphis, and then Memphis back to Salt Lake. But for whatever reason, where we were positioned when we started the trip, or the difference where we picked up this load and where we dropped off the last load, it was enough of a distance that it chose a southern route instead of the northern route. It's fine. I mean, it's either way, it gets us there. They're both the same. Just we're going to the 70 route this time up through Denver. Whereas before, we took we went up to the through St. Louis. This time we didn't go through St. Louis. We went up through Arkansas, up through Oklahoma City, and then up past Wichita into Kansas. Where last time we went up through St. Louis, across 70, and then at St. Joe we went up to the 80. So, I mean, it's not really that big of a difference. I think that it was better for us coming because of all the rain and stuff that was happening. There was quite a few storms, but again, I think that it was more lightning in the sky than it was rain. I don't know if with Alex, he did say he had some rain last night, but it wasn't like heavy rain. I had a little bit of heavy rain when we first started out leaving Memphis, but it wasn't bad. And hopefully, when I was looking at this a couple days ago, there was some snow in the in Wyoming, around Elk Mountain, I think it's called. It's kind of their mountain area. But I didn't see anything today. So, ready for spring to be here. We're almost in the middle of April. It's time to put the snow away. And at this point, any routes should be acceptable. The only thing that we normally will see now is just high winds in Wyoming, between Cheyenne and Laramie, or even Cheyenne and Oak Mountain, or somewhere in that area where it's usually some high winds. But yeah, we should be good to go until winter again. Hopefully, fingers crossed. So, as of right now, we don't have another load yet. We're still, delivery will be tomorrow, way early in the morning. I think I figured it's going to be between 4 and 6 a.m. tomorrow. So, yeah, that's it right now. Because we were doing our 3-4 hour reset, they did give us a nice stack. It was a really nice pick up in Memphis, go to Salt Lake, then from Salt Lake to Burbridge, Illinois, which was going to be 2 trips, but because we had to go out an extra day, we still got our pickup from the one carrier or the one customer that we were going to pick up at, but we lost our second load, which, you know, it's okay. We'll get another load. I just like it when they're stacked so I can see what I'm doing, kind of plan out where we're going to be doing our resets and what kind of time we have. It just makes it easier to me, that tells me I need to make sure that, number one, we always wear a mask anyhow. But that tells me that we need to try to get our vaccine to get us covered, because people are, I'm tired of it too, really. Especially as we're getting to the warmer times. Man, Memphis, it wasn't that it was hot, but it was humid. And then on top of being humid, walking outside with that mask on your face, it's not a fun time. But I'd rather not have a fun time because I have a mask on my face with a little bit of humidity than being on a ventilator or not being able to breathe, having my lungs destroyed, which, you know, I already have a couple things going against me. Number one, I was a smoker for years. Number two, I was overweight for years. And both of those have had effects on my lungs and my lung capacity. So COVID would be pretty difficult for me. You know, your lungs do regenerate. It's one of the organs in your body that does regenerate. But it does take a while. So I think it's been probably about 6 years since I've stopped smoking. Yeah, they say it takes about 10 years for your lungs to recover from the kind of smoke that you burn. I was a 3-pack-a-day guy, like really smoking the hell out of those. I was a freaking walking chimney. Yeah. And then, same with Alex. I mean, he wasn't a heavy smoker. He was a social smoker. But he's put on quite a bit of weight, too. And already it's difficult for him when we walk and we stop and he's, like, really breathing hard. So, you know, COVID would be a pretty substantial hit to him as well. So, with that, we definitely want to make sure that we get our vaccinations. Until then, we're going to continue to mask up. We wash our hands a lot. And we socially distance, so much so that when people, I'm in a line, I've had people try to step in front of me, thinking, you know, obviously, well, there's too much space here. Excuse me, I'm in line. Oh, sorry. Then they get behind you, and then they're like right on your back where you can feel the breeze on your neck. It's like, excuse me, can you back up? Socially distance, please. Thank you. I'm not a Karen by any means. I can be if they get crazy, but I do say, hi, can you back up a little bit just for some social distancing? And then they'll go, oh yeah, sorry, you know. So anyways, those are kind of some things that we need to do. Also, we just need to go in. Alex needs his checkup for his high blood pressure. And I need to go in for blood tests because I think I already talked about this on another video. I was on testosterone with Progressive. I had to go through getting shots to prove I was low T, and then they covered my my testosterone. It was $10 a month. Swift denied when I switched over. They denied my the coverage on it. So I went ahead and did a blood test, but because I was currently in treatment, I was at the right level. Well, yeah, that's because over the last year and a half, I had been on treatment, so my levels were. So now I've been off of testosterone now for 2 months. And so now when I go back in, I'll get that blood test again so they can see the deficiency. And then maybe Swift will cover it again. And hopefully Swift will give me 3 months supply instead of just a monthly supply like Progressive did. Especially with me being on the road, I can't be stopping in Phoenix every month to pick up my tea. So 3 months supplies is what's really needed. So that I, that's what we do with Alex's medications as well. It's every 3 months. Other than that, at some point we're going to need to redo a sleep study. So that's what's up. We're going to be looking at doing some home time in Phoenix when we can get our COVID appointments. I don't want to do it before then because we only get home time after once a month. So I don't want to come home and do a home time and then have an appointment like to pop up that same month, because then I'm not going to be able to. I mean, I can call and say, hey, I got an appointment at this time. They'll route us down there, but then they're going to want us to go back right away. And when I see, like, you know, some of the mild symptoms you get is like flu reactions, like a light fever, kind of feeling drowsy, a little achy. We really want to take an extra day off where we can, like, just in case those symptoms do come, we can get over them before we're driving in. Because, you know, when you're not feeling well and you're working, you can, especially if you're working from home, you can just sign out and go lay down. You can't do that with this because Alex isn't ready to drive. If I'm not feeling well, I can pull over, but then it's going to make us late. So, I mean, there's ways around things, but I want to keep everything headed in the right direction, meeting our goals, meeting our performance. I get very agitated, irritated, like yesterday, going into the shop. That irritates me because it's not time I'm getting paid for. The only time I'm getting paid is if I'm broke down and I'm in the shop for more than 24 hours. Then they give us $75 a piece for breakdown pay. But like for the 7 hours we were yesterday displaced because of the lights not working on the truck, we don't get paid for that. And it actually put us late on our delivery. Our delivery was due today by 10 o'clock. But because of us leaving 7 hours, eight hours late, eight because I had to go from there to go to get fuel and then go, it pushed us back. And this is an expedited order. It's supposed to be one of those orders that you have to be on time. So, I mean, yeah, it was not something that we could control. Still, it's very aggravating when things aren't smooth. I just feel like this truck is in the shop so much. There's another person on our fleet that my driver leader has who has the same truck. It's one letter or one number higher. So it's the exact same truck. It's a Kenworth T680, the 2021. And I asked her, I said, does our sister truck have as much problem? She says, no. So I don't know. I don't know if it's because I'm very adamant about doing my pre-trips and I'm checking everything so much. If I hear anything that runs me into that unsafe zone, I'm not going to just go and run with it. Especially after sitting in the terminal and hearing these guys talk about getting pulled in for DOT inspections and getting hit because things that they should have caught on their pre-trip. That's expensive. Those citations, number one, are points against us, and it always comes with a fine. And I'm not talking about a little $50 fine. I'm talking about $700, $2,000, $2,500, up to $5,000 fines. No, that's not this one. I worked too hard for that money and to be just seeing it go out the window with fines because I didn't want to spend 15 minutes to do my pre-trip walk around. So, I don't know if it's because I'm thorough on those pre-trips, but you know, it's the way I was trained. It was, you do your pre-trip. It's very important. You have an air leak, there's several things that can cause, jeopardize you, people on the road, your load, money for the company, not to mention the publicity, that's bad publicity, that if you kill somebody, it's on Swift. No, it's not something that I'm wanting to happen. So I don't know. I just feel like we're in the shop a lot. And the truck before this that Alex had, again, we were in the shop. So is it just me? Am I just very hyper focused on things, because obviously we take it in and they take the truck in and they fix it, or they take the trailer and they fix it. Every time I've taken it into the shop, it was a valid reason to be in the shop, right? But I just feel like, damn it, we're in the shop so much that if I wasn't in the shop this much, think of how much more money I'd be making. So, I don't know. Just a little bit there about that. Because as most of y'all know, I'm money motivated. And when things start messing with my money, I start getting cranky. Because I have goals. I'm pushing money in the bank because we want to buy a house. We want to get a short-term living situation, which is a fifth wheel and a truck, so that we can have a place when we come in, not always have to stay at a hotel. Every time we get into Phoenix, we actually jump into the RV and have a place to store our stuff. And then start building that money up to buy us a home. So, yeah, I think that, yeah, whatever. You know I'm money motivated, so those things are important to me. But anyways, so I need to stop here just a little bit for fuel. And so I'm going to jump off here. Just wanted to say good morning, kind of give you an update where we are. That's it. Good morning, Dad. I know you're probably, you gave me a holler in yesterday because I did this in the afternoon instead of the morning. So there you go. Here's your update. So, all right, guys, I love you. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Be safe. Mask up. Wash those hands. Socially distance. And get that vaccine if you're wanting it. If you're not, please continue to do your thing and mask up and support those of us who do want it, and those of us who do want it, support those that don't want it by doing the right thing, masking up, washing your hands, socially distance. If you don't want the vaccine, that's okay, but you still need to respect other people's space and their wishes for social distancing. So anyways, love y'all, take care, bye.